I think we just need to move from the old legacy models that we grew up with, where you know, had a TV budget that you allocated first, and then you started figuring out what could be done after that. I think because of the decisions of consumers and the way they're consuming media, the omni-channel approach that we all talk about, you have to look at where the consumers are, where your brand needs to be, and put them in positions where the message and the channel are aligned exactly with what their expectations are, especially, you know, out of the past year. There's no way to live in the past and focus primarily on what worked in the past. And I think that now we need to really focus on breaking the cycle of the media planning necessities of focusing on cost and focusing on specific outcomes and start moving to a much broader omni-channel, data first, consumer first way of thinking.
So what does that look like in that perfect world, that new world? What does it look like?
I think it just removes all the biases. I think it recognizes that the dollars will go where the dollars should go based on where consumers are consuming media and in what channels. I don't think it's broadcast first. I don't think it's necessarily digital first. I think it's consumption based. And you have to take a look at where your audiences are, what type of messages you're putting out there, what is your expected outcome, and how you can move from the old models that we had around, you know, mass reach with a specific outcome into more people over personas and quality over value, and trying to come up with a model that looks at it from a portfolio basis and not from a channel basis.
So tell us how that works with Mondelēz, or what your vision is in your category.
So CPG has always been the toughest, as you know. It's not something that you're able to get your own data, because obviously our products are sold primarily in retail environments. But I've been very fortunate to inherit, you know, a strategy that started 3 years ago that looked at the shift from mass reach and single digit ROI gains into more technology-based personalization that focused on return on investment. And now really moving into what I said before, which is the quality of what we're doing, over putting quality over value, and really looking at ways to execute what we call our empathy at scale program, which is to put the brand messages that consumers expect and want in front of them. So it's a unique opportunity in a CPG world where, you know, we don't own any of the data. We have to create partnerships and capture it ourselves. So what I'm trying to do is ensure that all of the campaigns we have globally for Mondelēz across all of our brands, from Oreo to Sour Patch Kids to Triscuits to Ritz Crackers, have a component of data capture and data activation at it. We're trying to make sure that data has an equal seat at the table, just like comms planning or creative or media, so that everything we do seeks to acquire data and then activate data so that we can deliver the brand experiences that we want based on what consumers are telling us. And I think, Andy, that's the most important thing, because consumers are telling us so much. And with what they're giving us comes great responsibility. And the value exchange that they expect from us is very different from what they expected in the past. Visiting a site and having that product show up at you as you made your way across the internet doesn't work anymore. Consumers expect their engagement to be delivered a value message that really makes a difference to them and gives them experiences and brand messages that they actually want and come to expect.
So tell us about the project with Oreo that you guys did recently.
Yeah, it's really cool. It was called Oreo ID. There was actually another project with Lady Gaga, but Oreo ID was actually a really cool concept, focusing heavily on direct commerce, direct to consumer and e-commerce. You could actually go to a site called OreoID.com and help design your own Oreo, your name, your color, your pack size, how many packs you wanted. And those Oreos would be custom made, delivered to your house for people to enjoy, just like they do all the time. But from my point of view, it then isn't a way for us to capture data from people who are raising their hand and engaging with the brand. The value of that data that we're capturing can then lead to a long-term ROI positive value exchange that just builds off the relationship that the consumer has said they wanted with the brand. And now, because of the technology infrastructure and the partnerships that we've spent the last 3 years building, we now have the ability to activate across the data that we acquire.
So Oreos are going cookie-free, so to speak, cookie-less.
Cookie-less and a cookie company. That's a great analogy. We have actually moved past. We're out of the third-party data business. We were preparing for what Google decided to do many years ago. So the shift from third-party data to first-party data is something that Mondelēz was preparing for over the past 3 years. Google is our main primary tech partner and our main media partner. We're all in with Google because we believe that their technology and their capabilities are able to deliver against the personalization mindset and needs that we have. So that's where we think the bets need to be. We believe in the strategy of the walled gardens. It certainly isn't a perfect ecosystem, but for us, we've moved away from the old days of, you know, having 150 partners on our media plans to maybe 5 or 10 partners globally. You know, we believe that in order to have this level of personalization and this level of technological advancement, you can't have a media plan with so many lines on it that you can't see. So we've allocated, you know, the lion's share of our budget to about 5 or 7 partners globally, and that's the expected strategy for the foreseeable future.
And finally, Michael, some innovations that you admire, people you admire, tech companies you admire, leaders who are doing important work from your perspective. Who or what comes to mind?
Well, I think from technology, I think, you know, like I said, I'm a little bit biased. I think Google, I think our partners at Mighty Hive have really gotten ahead of the curve into allowing brands to help build and activate the very, very complex data infrastructure and taxonomy and governance rules that allow for the activation that we do. It's not super sexy work, and a lot of it isn't seen, and tagging of websites and ensuring that, you know, all these things that we used to do back in the day now have even more importance. And I truly respect and value the data scientist folks and the engineers, like I said, at Google and Mighty Hive. And I think some of the folks in the CPG space, whether it's, you know, Unilever or L'Oreal or P&G or Coke or Amex, I think a lot of the clients that have always had direct relationships with their consumers have always, you know, been in, have held or acquired a lot of knowledge about their customers, had a 3 or 5 year head start on this. And I think those are the brands that, you know, I believe have, you know, seen the light as Mondelez has 3 or 5 years ago to recognize that there were gaps in the ecosystem that needed to be filled by technology advancements and partnerships, and finding partners that you could have a 3 to 5 year roadmap with and understand that there'd be some suffering and some pain along the way to build what we're building. But, you know, that's where we are today. We have to have a unique one-to-one personal relationship with our consumers and the brands. And there's no way to do that without a solid tech foundation and infrastructure.